केंद्र आरोग्य शाखा अधिकारी राजेश भूषण మాట్లాడుతున్నారు లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం।
जिसका अनेक बार उपयोग किया जा सकता है उसको पहने, हैंड हाइजीन का ध्यान रखें, हाथों को लगातार धोएं साबुन और पानी से, रेस्पिरेटरी हाइजीन का ध्यान रखें, जब भी आप खांसते या छींकते हैं तो या तो रुमाल रखकर करें या उसको ऐसे अपने हाथ के इस पर करें। इन्वायरमेंटल सैनिटेशन, इधर उधर थूके नहीं, कूड़ा कचरा न फैलाएं, तो ये चीज़ें बहुत महत्वपूर्ण हैं, क्योंकि एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वट एवर स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट डज अनटिल एंड अनलेस द गवर्नमेंट्स आर सपोर्टेड बाय कमिटेड एक्शन ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द कम्युनिटी एंड अ वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट अडेरेंस टू फिजिकल डिस्टेंसिंग, वेयरिंग ऑफ मास्क एंड हैंड एंड रेस्पिरेटरी हाइजीन, वी विल नॉट बी एबल टू विन दिस वॉर। सो देयरफॉर द इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी is of utmost and critical importance in winning the war against COVID-19. Thank you.
धन्यवाद सर। अब मैं रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ DGICMR से, सर आपके ब्रीफ।
थैंक यू। आई डू नॉट हैव एनी स्लाइड्स बट आई विल जस्ट से द इंडिया इज कंसिडर्ड एज द फार्मेसी ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। नाउ 60% ऑफ द ड्रग्स यूटिलाइज in the United States of America are of Indian origin. So these are generics produced in India, where India has established itself over the years. This is possibly well known to many people in the world. Having said that, important fact that is not known is that 60% of the vaccine supplied in the world, whether it be Africa or Europe or Southeast Asia or anywhere, are of Indian origin. So India is perceived and is an important player in the vaccines for supply for the world. That is the most important point to remember. So any vaccine candidate that is produced or developed in any part of the world will ultimately have to be scaled up by India, number one, or by China, because these are the two major producers of vaccine in the world, and India is 60% of the vaccines in the world. So that is an important point to remember, and that every developed nation, everyone who's trying to develop a vaccine, is aware of, and therefore they are in communication with India for the vaccine distribution, ultimately, if it's developed, to the whole world and manufacture as well. Over and above that, there are two indigenous candidate vaccines, and they have undergone successful toxicity studies in rats, in mice, and in rabbits. And these data were submitted to the Drug Controller General of India, following which both these candidate vaccines got clearance to start the early phase human trials early this month. Having said that, now these candidate vaccines got DCGI approval and for early human trials early this month, that is in the 2nd of July and actually 29th of June. Now they have got their sites ready and they are doing their clinical study on approximately 1,000 human volunteers each. At different sites. Some have got 12 sites, some have got six sites, so that's it. They are trying to do the early clinical testing for these two candidate indigenous vaccines. Over and above that, there are preclinical experiments for these as well as other vaccines being done, experiments being done at NIV Pune, which are trying to work day and night to do these experiments, because it is a moral duty to develop them as fast as possible, because more than 500,000 people have succumbed to this disease across the world. So fast-tracking this vaccine becomes very important. Recently, Russia has fast-tracked a vaccine which has been successful in its early phases, and they have fast-tracked its development, and the whole world has applauded it and congratulated that Russia has developed that vaccine. China has fast-tracked its vaccine program and has also fast-tracked its